featuring David Popovici from Romania, who had some amazing swims already here. And they are the ones who try to challenge the mighty David Popovici. There were some discussions whether his 48.08 swim yesterday in the semis would be a championship record, or should we could set it a championship record, his junior world record from the first day, which he set in the relay. Remember that 47.56 blast from Popovici in the relay was not only just the new junior world record, but also the fourth best time in the entire world on senior level. So he's fourth, he sits fourth with that in the senior world ranks. Let's see the other. Edward Dinedred, for instance, the Brit, was also outstanding. He was offered the re-swim after he missed his heat. But here you can see that Popovici is really a cut above the rest. Already half body length over the first meter. He's beyond the split of his junior record by 1/10. Under 13, it's 22.97. It's even a good result in the 50 meter free. So let's see, it's only the clock. Let's see the time he could achieve. Oh yes, it is. A new junior world record, 47.30. Amazing, amazing.
Hello, David. I'm Daria. I'm in the 7th grade at school 79. I'm part of the Erasmus team, and we would like to ask you some questions about your career so far as a swimmer.
Yeah. Hi, Daria.
So first of all, for those who don't know, who is David Popovici, the European swimmer who is feared by the Americans and Australians?
Well, firstly, I like describing myself just as a guy who swims fast, a kid just like all the other kids who found a way to express himself through sport. So that's how I say, that's how I describe myself.
How would you describe David Popovici as a teenager?
I'd say I'm pretty normal. I do all the usual stuff. I go to school, I have friends, I go out, I listen to a lot of music, I bike around through the city. I would just say I have less free time, a hell of a lot less free time, because I spend all of it swimming with my head on, underneath the water, and I have a lot of time to think about absolutely everything, so I never get bored.
Why swimming? What made you love this sport?
When I first started it at 4 years old, my parents were the ones who got me to the pool because I had some problems with my back. What made me love it? I don't know. It was just the feeling of freedom water gave me. And it made me feel, and it still makes me feel, extremely powerful. Just like Bruce Lee said, and I love this quote of him, be like water, my friend, be shapeless. And that's exactly how water makes me feel.
What would be the three tips you would give to younger kids who wish to become champions?
I think the most important tip, the one every kid should have sort of as his religion, is just to have fun. That's the most important thing, having fun. Then I guess it's just listening to your parents and being a little bit sort of disciplined, because you can't just have fun. You have to have fun, but still have fun in some rules, have some limits, set some limits for yourself. So
right.
The most important ones would be having fun and listening to the ones who know a little bit better than you.
Which is the most important competition you have taken part in? And what makes it so special?
Well, I have been to a lot of important competitions in the actual sense of it. I have been to the Olympics, I have been to Europeans, seniors and juniors. But the most fun I've ever had at a competition, and that's what I think is the most important one, was a really easy competition in Bulgaria in 2019, and it is the most special to me because I've made a lot of friends. I put my English skills to test there, and I loved it. I met a lot of Turkish people, a lot of Italians. I made a lot of friends, and I still talk to them to this day. So that was the most important because I got to communicate a lot.
We also know that you've been given different opportunities to train in other countries. And we'd like to ask you, why did you stay in your home country?
Well, I think the most important, now that I've reached this level, I've come to the realization that the most important thing to me is standing and training and working with the best people for me. And I chose to stay here, and I chose to stay here because I love the chemistry I have with my coaches, my dry land coaches, my swimming coaches, and all my friends here. And it's a different comfort than you'd have outside. And it's a lot easier to do your work because this is sort of a hobby and work of mine, the swimming I do. It's a lot better this way, standing with the people you feel comfortable with and with which you can know you can achieve great things.
How does a day in your life look like?
My day starts when I wake up 2 hours before training to eat something. Then I get back to sleep. I wake up 1 hour later. I go back to training. I warm up. I swim. Sometimes I have gym before. Then I go to school. After I finish with school, I have a little bit of rest until my second swim session for the day. And every session lasts 2 hours or more. So I spend most of my time at the pool, I think. I spend more time with my coach than with my family, if you don't count the nights. So I guess that's how a day normally goes for me. Sometimes when I have time, I like meeting up with my girlfriend or going out with friends. And I try to balance things out.
Obviously, as far as we know, you spend a lot of time swimming. But how important is school to you?
For me, school is just as important as swimming, because I don't think, and I think my parents taught me this, I don't think you can be a great athlete or great in anything if you don't have the proper education and if you're not surrounded by good people, teachers, colleagues, and all the people from school. Because if you find a good environment, then it sort of helps you grow and evolve and grow into a free spirit, just like Kosh Book does, the school I'm at.
Now, can you tell us how you're feeling when you're standing on the podium?
I think it's one of the best feelings you could ever get from a sport, being on the highest step of the podium on the first place, especially when you hear a national anthem. And in moments like those, I myself feel like it's all worth it. It's sort of a breathing moment in which I can say, okay, I've done it. Let's take a small mental break and let's do it all over again because I love it.
We know that the pandemic obviously took over the past 2 years, and there were lots of swimming pools closing their doors. Now, how did you manage to keep going?
We just had to adapt and overcome the situation because it caught everyone by surprise. We didn't have access to pools and we didn't have no water, our main element of training. So we adapted and we really quick, like we're talking now on Zoom. I was doing gym sessions with my coach on Zoom. I would get up in the morning, set my phone up in the living room and just start doing the workout with him supervising me, just like he would in real life. And so it was sort of an advantage for me, this pandemic timing-wise, because I had 1 year extra of preparing to qualify for my Olympics, which I actually managed, and it really helped me having this extra year. So basically, for me, I see it as being a good thing.
Who is your role model?
My role model, this is a difficult question for me because I've never had an actual answer to it. But I think the most accurate one would be my swimming coach. because ever since I started working with him, we've grown together. I started as a young athlete, he started as a young coach, and we evolved together, and now we're big together, and we're hoping to be even bigger and greater together in achieving things. So I'd say my coach, Adrian Radulescu, is probably my role model.
Okay. Now, before we say goodbye, I would like to ask you one more question. How do you imagine yourself in 2042?
Except for swimming, I don't have a solid plan on what I'm going to do in the future. I just know for a fact that whatever it's going to be, because at that point, I'll have retired, most probably, from professional swimming. And I just know for a fact that I will do something that I love and something that involves water, whatever that may be. Because I have no idea, but it will be something involving water, because I can't stay away from it.
Okay. Thank you, David, for helping us, and good luck in your future as a swimmer.
Thank you, Dario. Thanks for having me.
Pain-wise, it's very slow.
Oh, is it?
And you push it out, but all the time you are keeping the continuity going. Bending, stretching, everything. You know, suppose, you know, I mean, you just keep it moving.
It's like a belly dancer there.
Yeah, it is. I mean, to them, you see, the idea is running water never grows stale. So you got to just keep on flowing. Be formless, shapeless, like water. Now, you put water into a cup, it becomes the cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put it in a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Now, water can flow or it can crash. Be water, my friend.
If I lose myself, I lose it all. If I lose myself, I lose it all.